going from 1847 all the way to 1500s, tracking the same story, except that the older ones show Salt Lake as the point of origin.
Great Salt Lake is the largest inland body of salt water in the Western Hemisphere. It's located in the northern part of Utah.
Because, see, the story about the Mexican Indians or the Aztecs coming from the north is that they came from a body of water in an island. And so all the older maps show Salt Lake. It's amazing.
So this body of water was Great Salt Lake?
Exactly. Well, I'm not telling you that it's correct, but I can guarantee you that there is a map tradition going 300 years, that is from the 1500s to 1847. After the war, all this stuff magically disappears.
Sure enough, when we compare the treaty map with one that was published 21 years later, there's no mention of the Antigua Residencia de los Aztecas, the ancient home of the Aztecs.
Okay, do you think that there was a deliberate attempt to get rid of this information?
This country, they're used to telling people to go back, you know, go back where you came from. And if they're used to doing that, implying go back to Mexico, well, this would throw the story off, because to tell them to go back, they'd have to go back to the Four Corners.
That is incredible. Yeah. Wow. Well, I have to say that this evidence on the map and the legend of the migration of the Aztec over a period of at least a couple hundred years is really compelling. But is it possible maybe they originated up here in Wisconsin? Is there any other evidence that you found that makes this connection?
Probably the biggest evidence is the language. What we today call the Aztec spoke Nahuatl. And Nahuatl is part of a larger family, the Uto Azteca language. And that language goes from Canada, all the way down to Central America. For instance, Michigan and Michoacan have the identical meaning. It's a place of fishes. The word for shoe in the Nahuatl language is mocatzin. Mocatzin, moccasin. It's almost identical. So these words that I've talked about, they actually mean the same thing on opposite ends of North America. I always say that the borders we have are in our minds, not in geography, because you have many hundreds of mound cultures in this area. So it's not unreasonable to think that these people are connected to the people down here. That's not out of the realm of possibility.
Great, interesting history.